fuck, he's gonna run us over.
Like 16 times a night, plus him breathing like a freight train. Like he couldn't even breathe like normally.
You mean me struggling to breathe to stay alive and you were getting at it? Why don't I just fucking die? Just close my throat open. And then I'll stop snoring.
Well, we kind of need you.
Yeah, you do.
Me, what's this doing? What are we eating?
Tiger.
Bruno, I made him come in the wrong way. Oops, my bad.
Oh, hey there. It's Future, Jake and Carly and Dodge. We just thought that we would film a little like intro for this vlog because we realized we forgot to do that. So basically in this one we started off obviously in Toowoomba, went to Dickey Beach for 3 nights, then we went to Imbolc for 2 nights, which was a camping retreat, which we loved. It was really nice. Then we went to Teewah, was meant to be for 4 nights. We only ended up staying 3 nights and we had a couple of little hiccups along the way. So the gas blew, or not blew, the gas, we had a gas issue with the fridge. So our fridge didn't work. Lucky we had our backup fridge. Then our battery system, because we tried to
reboot it,
I guess.
And it needed Wi-Fi to
update.
Yeah.
So it was saying that we were running on full capacity on the battery when really we weren't, because it had flicked over from
lithium to AGM.
Yeah. So that was a worry for him. I said not to worry, but whatever.
So you don't worry about the jockey wheel literally just came undone. And you're like, oh yeah. Like.
I have him to worry about. You have the caravan to worry about. Then Jake started getting a really sore throat on like day one or two.
Day one.
And turns out he had bacterial tonsillitis. Yay.
Nearly died.
Has a history of his throat almost closing up, so I was like thinking, oh good, we're a barge ride with no service away from anything. If his freaking throat closes over overnight, I'm somehow gonna have to get him back onto the mainland.
And you don't have a license to drive this car.
Yeah, and I don't have a license to drive this truck. So, because it's a truck, not a car. I was meant to get that, but I forgot. We just ran out of time.
You didn't.
Anywho, Teewah was amazing. You'll see there's heaps of videos on Teewah. We just absolutely loved it there. But then obviously we had to cut the trip short to go to back to the Gold Coast because we needed to get the 1,000 kilometer service done on the van. So we just thought, why not just get everything fixed at the same time? So we went back to the Gold Coast to Pickering's Caravans, who we cannot fault. They have been absolutely amazing. Everything that we've needed, they have done on the spot. Like no questions asked. They have literally just, like I can't fault them. They've been so good. So if anybody needs a caravan, I highly recommend going to Pickering's Caravans, because they have just been a world of help. Anything that we've needed, we've just like sent Ben a message or given him a call and he has jumped straight onto it. So we left the Gold Coast in the afternoon. That night we got to River Shores. It's like just west of Caloundra. It's a hip camp. That was our first hip camp. It was $45 a night for just the site. So
it wasn't really a site, it was just sort of drive in, pick your own place.
Yeah, drive in. We stayed hitched up. It was really nice. It was on the river. It was just a really good stop for us for the one night. This vlog kind of ended. So we didn't film much over those days. I don't think I filmed really anything because it was just, it was hectic. We were just in the car basically the whole time. He was grumpy, standard. You were grumpy, you were sick.
Yeah, I was sick.
Oh, and he snored and kept me up for three nights straight because he couldn't breathe. How rude. I had a baby in my belly jumping on my bladder like a trampoline. I was peeing like 16 times a night, plus him breathing like a freight train. Like, he couldn't even breathe
normally. You mean me struggling to breathe to stay alive and you were getting mad at me? Why don't I just fucking die? Just close my throat open. then I'll stop snoring.
Well, we kind of need you.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, so. But that was the first trip. The first leg, which was good. See you in the next one. Just rocked up here, and then they like called us on. We're gonna stop, put some stuff in the fridge. They literally just like called us on, and we just drove on. So I'm hoping that we are on the right barge and going to the right place. Otherwise, we're just gonna not really much. But it was $24 for us.
Thanks, guys.
Well, I reckon we're going to find a good site because look at the line of people that are leaving here. Wow. Look at that. See you, bye. Bye. Bye bye. Baby. You talk to the bush? Just deflating the caravan tires to 20. Hopefully that's right. There you go, baby. We shall see, hey?
Ha 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 ha! I don't even bother dropping my car here.
And that was the entrance. So we probably shouldn't celebrate just yet, but I don't think that the big girl had any issues getting onto the sand. But look at this! I know that we're not at Teewah yet. That's Teewah out there.
They're all full.
Oh, what about back down that way?
There's a real good spot up there, bud.
Is there?
Yeah, right. It's weak.
That's empty, a good spot?
Yeah, and there's a lot of people have pushed back into the trees. So, is that like a sign that there's winds and shit, or?
Yeah, I don't know. Just put your seatbelt on, sir.
But, could be a bit of a mission for you. I kind of need you to get out and have a look, see if you like it.
Yeah.
So, I'm gonna come down.
There, I think. Alright, I'm going for a recce now. I'm running down the beach. It's so hot. Okay. Because then we still have ocean views. But then we have some tree cover as well. And then he can just drive straight in. You're coming the wrong way. Yeah, sorry about that. Do you want to just do that again? Come in that entrance?
Do that again. Whoa.
Because then we can park here. And we've got trees there. Yeah, I reckon set up there would be nice because then we've still got ocean views. I don't know. There's literally no shade or anything then. Tires that way. Oh no, the other way.
made it to the beach. Yeah, look, we're a lot longer than we thought we were. So coming in the wrong way on the ramp was probably not the wasn't the best decision, but we got out, chopped some trees down, but don't tell anyone. But yeah, I thought it was a success today. Truck went well on the beach, couldn't even really feel it. Only dropped the tyres to 30 psi and we had the vans on 25, so nothing serious. But Teewah was pretty hard. We did hit at low tide. If you were coming in at high tide, you'd probably be pushing hard up the beach. So all in all, it was pretty good. We'll go check out DI maybe tomorrow or the day after. But yeah, for now it's gonna chill, and Dodgy's pretty keen for some food. And then we'll check back in tomorrow.
Good morning. It is a beautiful day today. There's still a little bit of wind, isn't there, Dodgy? Jake's just ducked off because we've run into a little bit of an issue. Our fridge stopped working yesterday. So we had this red light that was flashing with like the gas symbol for like, well, like, well, when we got here, it's kind of started and then we kept on noticing it and then it just wouldn't come off that. So we ended up turning on our King's fridge, so that's just over there, and putting everything that was in the fridge into the other fridge because we were thinking that maybe it was because we put too much stuff in the fridge, but I don't know. We ended up turning off the gas last night and the fridge, just to be sure. I've still got stuff in the freezer, so fingers crossed it stays frozen. Oh, you're getting it all the way up there, the big one. Wow. So Jake's just ducked off to get some fuel and make some calls to book us in on Thursday to get a service, because we're due our service anyway, the first check over. We weren't really expecting anything to go wrong, but here we are. And then we found another flashing light last night on the battery, which we think is because we turned the gas off. Again, hopefully. So me and Dodgy are just hanging out this morning, aren't we, baby? Yeah, we've had breakfast. We're digging our cars in the sand. I'm going to convince him to let me do an upper body workout. Yes. And then we'll go and play on the sand and do some sandcastles. And I'm going to get a tan because I need it. And then this little girl is just living her best life. Look at the shell. See the shell? It's purple. Wow, that's got a living thing in it for sure. Show me how you throw.
No.
We've still got our Ugg boots on, so we've got to get dressed. Good throw. So we're happy. We're happy. And I think I could stay here forever. Caravan parks, this is where it's at. But when your fridge breaks, it's not ideal. Especially when your van's only, 6 days old. Call us crazy. We did just take it off-road after 5 days of owning it, so. Yeah, look, go big or go home, right? We go get your cars? Okay. And we're off. We're going to the beach. Dodgy and I are heading down to the beach. Get some sun on this bad day. Hey, we got some toys.
What a day.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, fast. Again, so Dodgy and I are just sitting here. I'm protecting him from the wind because it's pretty windy, and this guy has literally just pulled up at the front of where we're sitting, right there. This is right in front of our campsite. He's literally cast a line and caught a fish. Like, it was only a little one. Maybe he's using it for bait or something, or he threw it back, but look, he's getting another one. I need to go get my fishing rod out and go do some fishing.
Mommy.
Dodgy, do some fishing too? Yeah.
Daddy.
Daddy as well? We've got to get Daddy home first. Hopefully he comes home soon. They just caught another. Good morning. It is day
three,
I think. Day three here in Teewah. We figured out yesterday afternoon. Oh, big truck. Hey guys. The Val Vanderbangers on vacation. So we figured out yesterday, we went for a little wander to the bins, and turns out we actually are camping in the wrong zone. We booked in for camping zone number 3 and we are camping in zone 4, which I don't think is too big of a deal, but we just drove past zone 3 and there's some pretty good campsites. So we definitely know that for next time to actually drive the full length and, you know, figure out where our zone is and maybe scope out a easier site to get into. But you live and you learn, don't you, baby? Don't you, Dodgy? Yeah? So it's super...
Say hi.
It's super windy today. You can't tell because obviously in the car. But we're heading up to Double Island Point for the morning. Hopefully we can find somewhere that's a bit more protected. And it's just a short drive on the beach plan. And then we're going to pack up tomorrow because update on the fridge. Yeah, it's still broken. So we need to go back to the Gold Coast and get them to look at it at the caravan place, and then they'll have to take it to Dometic down in Burleigh. So we'll be down on the Gold Coast again for a day. Hopefully it's just a day, and then we can head up to Burram Heads from there. Otherwise we might be trapped in the Gold Coast. I say trapped, but whatever, trapped in the Gold Coast for a couple of days, hopefully not a couple of weeks. So fingers crossed. More protected down here. better get our boy. Do you want to get out? What's his foot doing? We might set up beside the car. Go that side so we're protected from the wind. This here is some live action, okay? We're getting the truck out of these holes that we've dug to be able to... Oh yeah. Oh dear. Okay, so I've sped this clip up because it took a little while. But basically what happened, we figured out on the drive down the beach, was that Jake forgot to turn the traction control off. I don't really know that what that means. Can you help me out?
So pretty much as soon as the car would have felt it started to spin, it would have like, I guess, cut some power to the rear so it didn't spin. But I mean, it got out, so we're all good.
We got out, and like I said, some live action. Oh, and the reason that we dug holes was because we needed to level the van, and that was the only way that we were going to get it done because we don't have airbags. So maybe one day we'll get them airbags. Not bad. What do you reckon, Dodgy? Oh, you want more. You want more.
Look, I was a bit worried for a second there, but...
You weren't worried?
I wasn't worried for a second.
like she, the wheel, the tires weren't even like digging in or anything. It was just, you just needed to give it a little bit more. As soon as you did, yeah, pulled it out. Yeah. Just gonna deflate the tires now.
Go.
Yeah, we're gonna put the, inflate. Gonna inflate the tires, give Dodgy some lunch while that's happening because it'll take its time. And then head in to Sunny Coast, get some food, because I'm starving. And that's all she wrote. Make our way to the Gold Coast tonight. Bye-bye.
Bye.
We hope you enjoyed this video. I'm working on not saying like, and Jake is working on his drone flying skills. So we'll try and sort that out for next time. But we'll see you then.